Today is Monday, June 21st, and the process is dead.
R.I.P. R.I.P. We had a good run. We had a good run. This was going to be the postseason where we judge whether or not processes actually work. Turns out they don't.
Well,
it was a it was a legacy game for just baskets being able to shoot.
Well, I was
turns out that if you can shoot, you're probably going to win an NBA playoff series.
I was going to say I didn't think it would catch up to him, but it finally did. Ben Simmons just refusing to shoot a basketball into a basket in a basketball game. It ended up that matters.
Well, he ended up not dunking. He's afraid of dunking too.
I thought
that if he had the opportunity to go up with like a nice solid two-handed slam dunk from inside the protected circle, I didn't think he'd be afraid of the basket in those circumstances.
Wait, but hold on, PFT. Rim protector Trae Young was there.
True.
So that's a scary thing.
No, actually, I'd like to now go back on my take that he should try dunking free throws because that wouldn't work either.
No, nothing works. He is allergic. I've never seen anyone just be like, I am not going to shoot under any circumstances. So we got a lot to talk about, but let's start with some Ben Simmons stats. So we talked about this on Thursday's show, but Ben Simmons now officially finished the last four games of this series without attempting a single field goal in the fourth quarter. That's your point guard.
Honestly impressive.
That's your point guard. He attempted three field goals in the fourth quarters of this entire series, two of them in the first. He did finish perfect 3-for-3, so there's one nice spin zone. Because he's now out of the playoffs, Ben Simmons has the lowest free throw percentage in a single playoffs in NBA history. So he beats out Shaq. He was 34.2%. Shaq's worst season playoff history was 37.4%. So that's another bad stat. And then finally, I mean, Ben Simmons, did you see afterwards Doc Rivers was asked, like, can he be a point guard on a championship team? He's like, I don't know the answer to that.
We'll see.
I will see.
Yeah, that's not great. It's not great when your head coach is saying that. Like, do you think that you can win an NBA game with Ben Simmons as your point guard?
And
MVP candidate Ben Simmons.
And I feel really bad for Sixers fans. I know that Hank, we're going to give Hank a chance to just rip them apart, which he will.
I honestly feel bad for Ben Simmons.
No, like, I don't.
Imagine making it to this stage in your professional career only to just discover your one glaring weakness, which is you can't score.
No. He can't shoot. He's afraid of shooting.
No,
I don't think he physically can shoot.
I think that he is, in fact, right-handed, and Kevin O'Connor has apparently been on this for a while.
No, he's...
A lot of people think that he's right-handed.
No, he's non-dominant.
Yes.
Neither hand.
He doesn't have a hand that works.
No hands work for Ben Simmons and shoot it.
I always thought that saying the Wayne Gretzky, Michael Scott quote didn't really make that much sense. He actually proves that you do, in fact, miss 100% of the shots that you don't take.
Yeah, like saying Ben Simmons can't shoot is actually wrong because, well, no, it's right in that when you say he can't shoot, you're saying he's a bad shooter. He can't shoot in that he mentally cannot make himself shoot.
Do you think he's got that disease, the brain thing, where you're afraid of holes? Remember when the iPhones came out and everybody pretended to be afraid of the camera?
Oh,
for like
that
a week?
Was like the even. No, that's
tryptophobia.
Yeah, tryptophobia.
Right? He might be afraid of holes.
He needs to get hit in the eye, so there's three rims.
Exactly,
like LeBron. It's that clip of him passing the ball when he was standing under the hoop with Trae Young coming over, who he's got like a foot on, was just. It's insane. Mm-hmm. I don't know how that happens in a basketball game, Hank. The floor is yours.
This quote just came out like a few minutes ago, so you probably didn't see it. But Joel Embiid said, I'll be honest, I thought the turning point was when we had an open shot and we made one free throw.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, and that makes perfect sense. You can't have a guy out there who does – that would be like if we went out there. I know. Obviously, Ben Simmons is a great defender. I'm not knocking him there. He had 11 assists. Like he or 14 – or no, he had – Sorry, 13 assists. So he's doing stuff that have an impact on the game. But if you put any of us in an NBA game, we would pass up open looks because we would be afraid of getting blocked.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we would do the same thing.
The only person that's compared, like Rajon Rondo early in his career was kind of like that, where he just didn't shoot or look for offense, but he also would at least shoot layups and, like, you know, if he needed to get a shot, he would get a shot.
Even if it was ugly, if you have an open layup,
you should probably consider taking the open layup.
Yeah, Joakim Noah would not look at the hoop when he was like at the foul line, but he would still, just to keep him honest, do his weird motion. It's absolutely like, I don't think I've ever seen anything like it. And listen, we also need to put some blame on Doc Rivers, who, like, we went through that on Thursday, but he's has not a great history outside of the one championship. And Embiid, look, Embiid is a great player, and he's the guy who you're going to build around if you're the Sixers. But he was so sloppy. Mm-hmm. Like, he's just a sloppy guy.
He loves falling down. I think his hands might be too big.
He might just be sloppy.
There's just, he's all fingers. He's just doing a lot of poking. And there were a few times where, you know, it was clear that he was going to be the person that was going to provide all the offense. And if you make him drive to the hole in the fourth quarter, he's going to, like, bounce it off his shins every time. Like, I think he has a little mental issue, too. It's like they built an entire team out of Chuck Knoblauchs when he forgot how to throw the ball to first base.
Except the only guy who could play is Doc Rivers'
son, or his
son-in-law, who's out there playing in Seth Curry, who actually was playing well, but that's pretty much it.
And he was the one guarding Kevin Herter.
Kevin
Herter.
We got to talk about the Hawks, but I want to say one thing though for the Sixers fans, because I actually, enough time has passed, an hour has passed since the end of the game. I actually think that if you're a Sixers fan, in a weird way, this is for the good. And I know that makes no sense on face value, because you can go through the entire process and you can point to a million different things that went wrong. You wish you had Jason Tatum, all these things. You know, you wish you kept Jimmy Butler, traded for James Harden. But at the end of the day, this was going to happen no matter what. Ben Simmons does not want to shoot basketballs.
But they've lost so much value with him.
Of course. But
it's better you find out in such a spectacular failure than to have it be like a slow, like, death from a thousand paper cuts where he kind of doesn't show up for series at a time. It's better that it happens in a great big way that's impossible to ignore.
But he's so young, he could go somewhere else and be nasty.
But someone will think, like, I think he still will have trade value because someone will think, I can fix that. I can make him better, because he still has elite levels to his game. It's just the whole point of shooting a basketball into a hoop is the game, and he just doesn't want to do that.
He might be the best player in the NBA if there wasn't a basket.
Yes. If
it was keep away.
If it was Hoosiers when they're not allowed. No, they didn't get to play with a basketball.
Mm-hmm.
When that scene when they got to when they weren't able to practice the basketball.
The four corners era.
Yeah, Ben Simmons would be elite. Mm-hmm. I think that if you're a Sixers fan, in a weird, deep-down way, I know how terrible this is, and that was truly horrific, the way it all unfolded and the way they lost these games. I really do think there's a silver lining of, like, this wasn't going to work, and now at least it has to change.
Yeah, and also, if you're a Philadelphian, your native mindset is always just being pissed off at your sports teams.
Popping the Super Bowl DVD.
This is like, you're like a duck in water if you're a Philly fan, because now you get to call into Ant, Big Ant, and Angelo and be like, you got to blow the whole thing up, Big Ant. I'll take my answer off the air. You know, like, this is what you've practiced for your whole life.
Yes.
If Philadelphia became an elite sports city, I mean, well, let's think about it this way. After they win a Super Bowl, they grease up their light poles. People climb up them. Who knows how many lives were saved by Ben Simmons not being able to shoot
a
foul shot?
It's true. Yeah. If you're a Sixers fan, if you're a Philly fan right now, you pop in the Super Bowl DVD, you think about Chase Utley and Jimmy Rollins, and you just kind of, it's actually for the better, because this was never going to work, and you hope that you get someone who can make Joel Embiid not have to turn the ball over in every fourth quarter and fall on the ground because he's the only offense. Mm-hmm.
Shout out Kevin Herter, though.
You know what else Philadelphia people should do?
What?
No.
At least be happy that they don't have to play the super team, you know, the Nets.
Yeah.
That's true.
They got to beat them. I do want to give credit to the Hawks. Kevin Herter, max contract right now. Sign it. That was a legacy game for him. And so Trae Young was terrible tonight. We can all agree. It was probably the most fascinating game to watch, in that it wasn't a very, like, great game. Game 7 Nets-Bucks was a great game. This game, though, was so fascinating, because you had one guy in Ben Simmons who refused to shoot, and then you had Trae Young, who was having a terrible, terrible night and still was like, fuck it, I'm shooting every shot from wherever. And, you know, he ends up, like, it wasn't a great night for him. He did still make it happen with the assist. But the Hawks in general, no one picked them to go to the Eastern Conference Final. They are a great story. They're, like, I'm sitting here and I'm still thinking like the Sixers were a better team, but the Hawks deserve to win this series. They were resilient. Like, they came back from those games that they won where it was just horrific for the Sixers, and they deserve all the credit, and Trae Young's a superstar.
And we get to see another couple weeks of Trae Young doing just silencing crowds. The emergence of Trae Young, the troll, has been my favorite part of these playoffs, with the exception of the Suns and four guy. But, like, I love watching people get pissed off at Trae Young because he seems to actually enjoy playing that role of being the heel.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
He's really good at it.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
I mean, I'm trying to, like, I was getting all worked up for Nets Sixers next round. So I'm trying to figure out ways where I'm going to pretend that I'm actually excited about Hawks Bucks. Kevin Huerter, sweet nickname. They call him Red Velvet.
That's great.
Which is amazing. If you're a redheaded player, you're either going to have the best nickname of all time or the worst.
Yeah.
It's like the most, it's an extremely polarizing thing if you have a ginger that's good at sports, because you either have to like just call him like the Red Mamba, like Scalabrine, but Red Velvet is just, it's the smoothest nickname.
Yeah. And they deserve a ton of credit, because I didn't expect this, and I was definitely wrong. And Trae Young is, having that type of guy on your team who is, even if it's not going well for him, he's like, one, he's going to help in other ways, but two, he's never going to stop. He has the exact polar opposite confidence of Ben Simmons.
Mm-hmm.
He could miss 100 shots in a row and he will still take a three-pointer from the logo and be like, this one's going
yeah,
in.
Yeah, next one.
Ben Simmons will pass up a million shots in a row, and on the millionth one, he'll be like, yep, still going to pass it up, too scared to shoot.
Yeah, we got sweet Lou Will, too.
Yep.
Even Pepper Lou.
John Collins just jumping all over people. I mean, they're a fun team. And I'll talk myself into it. And the Hawks crowds have been awesome. Like, yeah, we're going to get into this. It's good. It's good. It's good. Good.
Everything's fine.
I would have liked to see the Nets, but it's good. It's good, guys.
Mm-hmm. Hank, do you have any last thoughts for Philadelphia fans out there? I know that it's kind of been like a tough love situation between them. Have you grown to respect them?
Well, yeah, I mean, I think they tried their hardest. It's been, you know, like 20 years since they made the Eastern Conference Finals. They were so close this year, and I think eventually they're going to make it to the Eastern Conference Finals.
You're going to put your reputation on
the line? I do believe, I truly believe, you know, as much as I've said bad things about Philly, it's only been, you know, my honest opinion, and I do believe eventually they will make it to the Eastern Conference Finals. Okay. So that's, you know.
That's, just trust the process.
Yeah, you can go to bed at night being like, yeah, a few more pieces here and there, different coach.
At some point. It's going
to
happen.
A bunch of injuries to other teams and other players. We can make it.
Yeah.
I wonder if Bogdanovich is.
It's not like Atlanta
hurt?
Was losing a starter or anything and one of their best bench players.
Yeah. But, fuck, man. Bogdanovich is definitely. You know what's funny is I always forget Tony Snell is on the Hawks. And if Tony Snell, if like the Hawks play the Suns and it's Tony Snell versus campaign in the finals, that would be very funny.
Yeah.
For me, just me personally, pretty much. But. The Hawks deserve credit. I want to make sure that we stop, pause, and say that this team deserves a ton of credit, because they just haven't given up. Like, they have been, people pick the Knicks, people pick the Sixers, and they just fucking, if they have to win it ugly, they win it ugly. If they have to win it with Trae Young hitting every shot, they win it that way. Bogdanovich, all those guys. Kevin Huerter is like, fuck, man. The Kevin Huerter game. Mm-hmm. It happened. That happened. Kevin Huerter game happened.